Do you want to create your own Stargate portal for an hypnotic spaceship endlessly searching for a landing spot? If so, I've got you covered. In this tutorial, you'll learn a quick and effective way to build a 3D rig to control spinning objects in After Effects. This one is going to be a spin-tacular ride. All right, we're going to start with those models that are free to download from Sketchfab. The links are down below. I just want to show them to you and give credit for their creators. So this is Mr. Space Penguin. I'm going to use this sand and stone portal. And from 44-bit, what a cool name, we're going to use this Radiant Pillar BC1. All right, so inside After Effects, I'll create a new composition. I'll name it Stargate. I'm using this preset, so HD 25 frames per second, and I'm going to set the duration to 4 seconds and click OK. I'll start by dragging the sand and stone on top of this, and then I'll scale the model to 300%. Then I'll add a new camera. We'll choose the 35mm preset, and I'm going to pull out and start to bring it somewhere over here so I can see most of it. We're going to frame it in a moment, but before doing so, let's just drag down the spaceship. Now, in this case, it comes in a strange place, and also the anchor point is not centered, so I'll hold down Command and double-click on the Pan Behind tool, which is going to set the anchor point to the middle of the object. I'll then press V to return to the Selection tool, and just raise it up and scale it to, let's say, 35%. I'll take it underneath the camera and then I'll reframe the shot. So I'll hold down Option to access the camera tools and then let's push in with right click, orbit around the scene. So something like this. I think I want a lower angle, and then middle click is going to help us pan everything down. So then I'm just going to try and find an angle that we are not going to see the edges of this model. Now I want to create some sort of a background. So I'll create a new solid. I'll name it BG. I'll set the width and the height to 3000. Color doesn't matter because I'll apply the gradient ramp effect. And then I'll drag it underneath those two layers. Convert this layer to a 3D layer. And then for the gradient ramp, I'm going to sample the start color for one of the stones here, so a dark gray. And the end color, I want something from the sand. But I'll click on it and make it a little bit more dull, so something like this. Now I'll open up the background settings, and for its geometry option, since this is a pixel-based layer, we can use curvature. So I'm going to take the curvature all the way to 100% and then add a few more segments. So let's go with 20. Then I can press P and push this guy and then raise it so we're not going to see the edge. Now if I switch from active camera to custom view 1 and again zoom out just a touch, you can get a sense of what I'm doing here. So I'm creating half a cylinder around those objects using the same colors, which is going to serve great as a background and also catch shadows. I'll press Escape to toggle back to the active camera. So this is a cool keyboard shortcut. Escape is going to toggle between the last two 3D views. And now we can close the background layer. Now let's create a 3D rig. It's going to be a very simple yet effective 3D rig that you can use not only with these elements, but with whatever you are building in 3D to move, rotate, and change the axis of elements and animate them in a predictable way. Let me show you how. First, I'll select the spaceship and just move it where I want it to be. So something like this is a good starting point. And then I'll go to the layer menu and choose new and create a null object. I'm going to rename this one axis and duplicate it and name this one rotate. All right, both of them should be 3D layers. And then I'll select the axis one and use the 3D gizmo to bring it up as well as move it to the right of the pillar's gate. Then I'll press R to isolate the orientation and rotation, create a keyframe for the Y rotation, and then go to the end and change the revolution to minus one. So counterclockwise. Now I will take this keyframe and move it beyond the last frame of this comp. And this is going to allow us to create a perfect loop. You will see what I mean in a moment. For now, I'm just going to take the rotation null and bring it up so it will be more or less above the spaceship. So something like this should work. And now I'll parent this rotate to the axis. I'm also going to change the color so it will be easier to see. And then I'll click on Draft 3D, which will allow us to view everything in real time. Now, if I'm going to move my current time indicator, you can see that the rotate yellow null is spinning, taking the anchor point, the middle, from the axis. And this means that we can move each one of them and change the animation. So let me show you how this works. I'll close the axis properties. I'll select the spaceship and I'll parent it to the rotate null. And I'm just going to preview the comp. And basically this is the main setup here. Now we can still control each one of the layers individually. So we can select the rotate null, maybe scale it just a touch, and then create keyframes for the position, as well as maybe the Z rotation to create some interesting angles. So maybe we'll start with plus 10 degrees for the Z. And then over here, at the beginning, I'm going to lower this spaceship so it will almost touch the elements underneath. Then I can go to the middle and I can change the null behavior. So I can raise it up as well as change the Z rotation to something different. So let's go with negative 20. And now this is very important. I need to copy and paste the first two keyframes. Otherwise, I won't have a perfect loop. So I'll copy and paste them. And then I'll select everything and press F9 to easy ease the motion. And let's evaluate how this looks. I like it. We can maybe even take this one a bit higher. As well as if we want, we can push it left or right, depending on how much we want to see it inside the frame. Maybe something like this. And now that we have the basic animation, we can make it more beautiful by adding some lights and shadows. All right, I'll start by creating an environment light. Make sure it is casting shadows and I'll click OK. Now I know that I want to use some HDRI image to colorize the scene. And I've got this one from Polyhaven. The link is down in the description. I'll drag it down to the timeline behind the background and switch it off. Reselect the environment layer. And for the source, I'll set it to use this Blue Photo Studio image. And then to see the shadows, I'll need to uncheck Draft 3D. And we can play with the X and Y rotation. So I'll start with the X rotation. I'll move it to somewhere around maybe 70 degrees. And for the Y rotation, again, I'll move it until I'll see something interesting, which makes sense. So I think 130. And you can see how we are seeing the shadows on our background. Now it's just too dark here. So to fix it, I'm going to create another light. I'll go to the layer menu again. Choose new light. This time I want to create a point light and I'll sample an orange color from the ground here and also raise the intensity to maybe 300. I'll click OK and this is going to place the light in an arbitrary place. I want to place it in a very specific place behind this arc. So I'll switch on Draft 3D for a moment and I'll press Escape to go back to Custom View 1 and then I can drag the light and place it exactly where it needs to be. Let's just make sure that it is located in the desired place. So something like this, it's not. So I need to move it yet again. And of course you can use the orthographics view, but I'm lazy, I don't have time. I just want to finish with it quickly. So I think that this is going to work for us. I'll press Escape again to return to the active camera and then check off Draft 3D. Now, this light is just lighting everywhere. I just want it to light the area behind the spaceship. So again, I'm moving it to where I need it to be. And to control the fall-off, we can actually set it to smooth and change the radius to, let's go with 1,000. And this will allow the light to shine in 1,000 pixels radius. And of course, you can also play with the fall-off distance. Now, to make this scene less grainy, go to the renderer options and then change the render quality and the shadow resolution. So I'll set the render quality to 20 and the shadow resolution to full and then click OK. It will take longer to render, but we'll have much more smoother and nicer result. We can still play with the light position. I want to drag it a bit more closer to us, really just light this area to just create an accent color over here. And I think this looks great. So let's go to the start, then maximize the frame and preview the result. And this is it. Now all that's left to do is to create a GIF animation that captures this endless spin forever, because hey, aren't we just circling around ourselves? Looking for a spot to land, park, or maybe we need to just pause for a moment. But why stop now when there's so much more 3D godness to dive into in After Effects? Hit the like, subscribe, and jump straight into this playlist you see on screen for even more cool tricks.